my poor friend. The next morning, he still tried to keep me from going to the beach with her. The next morning, he still tried to keep me from going to the beach with her. So he came with us, and again, man himself disappeared. So we looked for him, to an hour. But in between, I went to his truck. He had left his key on his towel, and found his wallet and his phone, and realized that he had made the whole thing up. I started to look for him and worry again. I was disgusted. My friend helped me to move out, and I went to my brother and never came out for 3 weeks. I set up a mattress in his closet because there were no extra bedroom, and I hoped to never see him again. I started to write about it in my novel, Roman Chapter Book. Hey, by the way, this is when I wrote this story in 2000, and pray to God he will not kill me. For the first time ever, he left me alone for 3 full weeks. I'm alive again, but no. After that, he followed me for another full year. Days and nights, begged me to go out, tried to buy me off with money, sat on or under my car, blocked me to drive off my parking spot. I found him in my new apartment. One day, he had found a way to make a double of my keys. He hid in a closet after I was in for hours. The evening, and he jumped out of it. When I asked him to stop, he'd say,
I'll kill you and your family.
You do as I say, and if you ever date anyone, I will cut your throat. Reading this now, I realize how naive I was to take his threat seriously or even think that he respected me. I would have ended the circus long ago. I felt bad for him. I imagined he was so alone, so desperate, so obsessed to be with me, that he had uncontrollable behaviors that were not preventable. I felt being spied on 24/7 from my job, my place, my school, my work, my every move. I was going to a massage school now, and he'd be waiting on me after this end of the day, making sure I wouldn't date anyone. And it works out for him, because I dated none for 1 entire year and 5 months, too afraid of what he will do and how I would end up if I did. I was learning to never look at a man and turn my head away like a slave woman. I keep hearing him in my head saying, you're a whore. You'll flirt with everybody. You can't stop. All you want is sucking dicks. Sorry for this non-PG-13, but I am repeating words for words here so you can picture yourself there with me. Now I was convinced I was a dirty whore, and I should force myself not to look at any man's body shape or eyes. But one day, I went out, dancing. I needed a break from him and all his accusations. Isaiah wasn't around, and I met a guy, very sweet and charming. We go back to my place, and who do we find on my sofa? Him, of course. So we tried this easy way at first, to ask him to leave. But he wanted a physical fight, a boxing fight. Mano de mano with my date, and started to punch him right in the face. So I said, okay, let's go. And we left him in my place. Since he wouldn't get out, he had that cold, hysteric, psycho look in his eyes. A very dark, freaky look. We drove off. We crossed a police car. When my new friend asked me to stop and lay my window down and yelled at the cops. We have been harassed, and there is an intruder in her place who is violent and aggressive and wouldn't get out. We came back with the 2 policemen. He had magically disappeared. After all this time, all I needed to do was call the police. I never knew that he would finally stop following me everywhere if I did. I sound very stupid, I know. But when you think you love someone or are totally compassionate towards this other person, you imagine that they are capable of doing the right things with the right guidance. But my little French life background, culture and experiences was very far from the one of a Guatemalan raised in a third country and moved in this US at age 12 with a third grade education and no family around him to guide him. I had invested my time. I had invested my time becoming his reading, writing, educative guru teacher, trying to make an impact in his life. It's a little wanting to see miracle happen. But after that day, he left me alone, for good. He never truly appreciated all I did for him, and never said sorry either. I still had to go get a restraining order, and a few years later, he found a way to see me again at the mall, with his flowers and a fake gift. But those times were closure, and I never saw him again. I was free. His name, by the way, if you wonder, is Isaiah Ramos. He was around 4 years older than me. And I believe in return to Guatemala long ago.